from the first tools to crossbreeding with Neanderthals. Stay tuned in number one to find out why we were the only form of humans to survive. Number 10, Homo. Scientists have traced back the history of our species over millions of years, and here we will focus on a section of our history about the Homo genus that encompasses modern humans and several extinct species which are classified as ancestral to or closely related to modern humans. As the study of our history is heavily reliant on the remains of our ancestors, the study of the Homo species has developed significantly as scientific advancements have enabled us to delve deep into the biological and genetic similarities and differences we share with early humans. Even today, there is still a lot of debate about what defines a member of the Homo species and when different species or subspecies appear and disappear. Number 9, Homo Erectus. Homo erectus, sometimes referred to as upright man, is believed to have developed in Africa around 2 million years ago. Unlike some of the other extinct humans, it is widely accepted that the Homo erectus looked and behaved in a human-like way. They are the oldest known early humans to have possessed modern human-like body proportions. They walked on 2 feet and used these feet to march out of Africa to ultimately spread out across Eurasia. This makes them the earliest human species known to have migrated long distances. They use tools like us, and some academics like Professor David Everett even believe that they used language to communicate, though not as complex as ours. This is something that has normally been associated with Homo sapiens alone, but Everett believes that they wouldn't have been able to do the things they did without being able to communicate beyond the sort of communication we see in our closest living relatives today, such as the chimpanzee family. Obviously, there are those who don't agree with Everett's view, and his theory is controversial. But if he is right, it would mean that language was not just used by us Homo sapiens. Like nearly everything about our early history, there are still plenty of things we don't know about Homo erectus. Like, did they grow like us? In other words, did they have a growth spurt during their adolescent years? And while we know they used fire, we don't know how widespread or regular it was. Number 8, Neanderthals. Homo neanderthalensis, also known as Neanderthals, are our closest extinct human relatives. The first skeleton was discovered in 1856 by a group of workmen in the Neander Valley in Germany. At first, they thought the bones belonged to an animal, so they gave them to a local teacher. But scientists later identified them as early humans. Since then, over 400 Neanderthal bones have been found in the same valley. Neanderthals lived in Eurasia 200,000 to 30,000 years ago and shared the planet with early modern humans. In appearance, they are both similar and different to us. Although they were shorter, had prominent brow ridges, and a wide nose, their characteristics are similar to ours. Early explorations in the study of Neanderthals often referred to them as being dumb brutes, but this was not the case. And more recent investigations by scientists and archaeologists has changed this opinion, though you still get incorrect representations of Neanderthals in pop culture. In fact, the discovery of tools, evidence of burials, and the ability to control fire suggests that this species was in fact rather intelligent. There are even some finds that suggest they created jewelry. Although we've underestimated our closest extinct human relatives in the past, now we can at least admire their development in the correct way. Before we move along, don't forget to take a moment to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more videos from Zero to Hero. Number 7, Hobbit humans. Today, on average, men measure 7 foot 7 inches and women 5 foot 3 inches, but this hasn't always been the case. In our own species, Homo sapiens, there have been variation through the millennia. When we first arrived on the scene, we were hunter-gatherers, and as a result, had bodies that reflected the need for stamina and strength. But this has changed over millennia, but only slightly. Our closest extinct relatives, the Neanderthals, were more or less similar to early Homo sapiens, just maybe a bit bigger and stockier. But there are other Homo species that were remarkably different from us and others. The most notable was Homo floresiensis, nicknamed Hobbit. These remarkable non-Homo sapien humans are believed to have stood at just over 3 foot 3 inches tall. That's like the height of your average-sized dining room table. As to why they were so small, there's a lot of debate about this. Some have suggested that it could have been due to food shortages, which resulted in insular dwarfism, something that has been observed in other animal species that shared the small island of forests. But many have criticized this theory, and others have suggested other theories, like the Laron syndrome hypothesis, the endemic cretinism theory, the Down syndrome hypothesis, and others. Nevertheless, we'll never have all the secrets to this mystery. Number 6. Using fire. One of the most influential and life-changing acts that humans have done is gained the ability to create and control fire. It allowed for cultural advancements, warmth, and light during the night, and enabled them to improve hunting methods. Some have even argued that cooking meat was fundamental in our development to modern humans. Quite simply, we might not be here today if our ancestors hadn't mastered fire. Some have claimed differing dates for the earliest evidence that members of the Homo range first controlled fire, ranging from 1.7 million years to 200,000 years ago. Widely accepted evidence for the controlling of fire by Homo erectus dates back about 600,000 years ago, and there is plenty of evidence for this. Our ancestors would have seen forest or brush fires raging across large swathes of the landscape, killing everything in its path. And their ability to manipulate fire, even fire started naturally, changed everything. Number 5. Tools. One of the main characteristics for grouping species together under the Homo genus is the species' ability to create and use tools. Stone tools are the oldest tool and tool-making instruments in the archaeological record, and were only replaced by iron and bronze in the last couple of thousand years. Historically, we have attributed tool-making to ancestors from only the Homo genus. However, a recent find has threatened to completely rewrite the history of tools, and has even brought into question whether tool-making is something that only our Homo ancestors did. Until this discovery, it was believed that Homo habilis was the earliest of our ancestors to use tools, but the recent discovery is 700,000 years older. Some believe the use of tools might suggest that the users were smarter than we originally thought. This is perhaps not that surprising, as tool use isn't actually specific to the Homo species, and we can even observe this in the natural world today. Like chimpanzees, they use stone hammers and have made specialized tools for hunting ants, or like dolphins, that spend more time hunting with tools than any other non-human animal. Number 4. Jewelry and art. Jewelry has been around for thousands of years, from seashells, animal teeth, gems, and gold to ones made from modern materials, like plastic. Jewelry has been used for many reasons, like showing status and wealth, or being worn as a symbol of someone's affections. Art and the creative abilities required to create jewelry have historically been attributed to Homo sapiens only. While this may be the case for most of them, this might not be completely true in the case of Neanderthals. There is some evidence that they practiced some similar behaviors to us, burying their dead, adorning themselves, and art. Recent research, published in February of 2018, suggests that Neanderthals were capable of creating art. Some suggest that they are responsible for a cave painting in Spain, which the researchers believe was painted around 65,000 years ago. That's 20,000 years before modern humans even arrived in modern-day Europe, around 45,000 years ago. Nevertheless, although this is an appealing idea and there is possibly some evidence to suggest it, there are still a lot of unanswered questions. And more evidence will need to be found and researched to confirm that Neanderthals were prehistoric artists. Number 3. Rafts. As all pre-modern boats are made of wood, it is only under the right conditions or in an exceptional circumstance that archaeologists find the remains of them. And the boats used by our earliest ancestors are believed to have been more like a raft than a boat. Nevertheless, it's still floating objects that could evidently get someone from one island to the next. With only a small amount of boats surviving, and the oldest of them only being 8,000 years ago, one might be wondering how we could possibly know they used boats. Well, we knew that, in recent times, Homo sapiens used boats to get to Australia. But evidence dates back even further than that. Many believe that Homo florentiensis arrived in Flores on bamboo rafts 900,000 years ago. So boats of some sort must have been around for a very long time. Number 2. Human-Neanderthal inbreeding. So we know humans and Neanderthals lived in Eurasia together for quite a time, and while some people continue to refuse to acknowledge recent scientific finds, there is mounting evidence to highlight that modern humans from Eurasia bred with their Neanderthal relatives. Scientists have found that Neanderthals contributed approximately 1 to 4% of the genomes of all non-African modern humans. Though it should be highlighted that we do have a skeleton of one modern human who lived about 40,000 years ago that has been found to have between 6 and 9% Neanderthal DNA. Neanderthals could not have contributed to modern African people's genomes because Neanderthals evolved and lived exclusively in Eurasia. Therefore, they could not have bred with the humans living in Africa at the time. Nevertheless, even with some interbreeding between modern humans and Neanderthals, most of our genomes still derive from Africa. So, how far back in history were they doing this? Well, recent evidence from 2016 suggests that human-Neanderthal interbreeding was happening as far back as 100,000 years ago. Number 1. Why is it just us left? Archaeological evidence clearly highlights that we have ancestors and closely related species of humans that have lived all over the world. And while some existed and even lived together at the same time, others are separated by hundreds of thousands of years. When we came on the scene around 200,000 years ago, we shared the planet with several other species of the Homo genus. But we are the only ones left today. So, where did everything go wrong for our ancestors and the other closely related species and subspecies? Well, as we've already covered, some inbred with Homo sapiens and left their genetic mark on millions of people, but others simply died out. While we don't know enough about all of them to ascertain why they died out, we do know a big deal more about Neanderthals, and as a result, many have written about the possible causes of their extinction. Some researchers believed it was due to climate change. Neanderthals were good at living in cold environments, but couldn't adapt to the change in climate, and consequently, the changes in hunting conditions of Europe at the end of the last ice age. Others have suggested that Homo sapiens had developed better tools, hunted a wider variety of game, or were simply better at adapting to changes. Perhaps if we didn't develop in this way, we might have faced the same outcome as others. There is likely no one main factor for any of the different species and subspecies, but there is still a lot more research needed here. It's hard to capture in a couple of minutes the long and complex nature of human history. There is still plenty we don't know about Homo sapiens, let alone the other members of the Homo genus. And these are only one, albeit a large and significant part, of the development of humans from the more ape-like creatures our distant ancestors started out like. Tell us what you think about the development of human existence in the comments below, and take care.